Hey, what's up guys? My name is Alec Hibbett. We are back again on the RTS day with some more Age of Empires 2 action today. We're doing HD edition. And yeah, I am good. This is a 1v1, actually. I did a while ago. And I am Sovereign. I am the Red Mayans. And I am against Reginald Kenneth. And Reginald Kenneth is spawning on the top left as the Huns. So yeah, it's a Huns versus Mayans. We were both random, and this is the map Yucatan. I have not played in this map very much. It's an interesting map. I'm gonna keep the fog of war off and try and go through my perspective as best I can. Definitely let me know if you guys want me to go through, like, analyze it as like a game, or just go through my perspective and see what I see or whatnot. You know what I mean? Definitely let me know in the comments below how you guys want me to do it from now on. I definitely want to do more 1v1s like this. I might do like a quest to something, like, and try and get better, like a quest, say 1800 ELO. So I'm like at like 1650, I think, or something like that right now. I'm not very good. I'm okay, but I'm not very good. There's a lot of things I can clean up in my game. But yeah, using the Eagle Scout to scout. Oh, very funny. Oh, using a scout to scout. Who would have thought that? I didn't. But yeah, you know, just scouting around, trying to see where my choke points are in this map and where I can wall off for any early aggression. He's the Huns. I'm expecting a night rush or something along those lines as usual. Archer rush possible too. I think I'm going for an archer rush in this game. I think, if I remember correctly. But yeah, I spawned with a ton of turkeys. Like, there was so many turkeys. I think like 8 or 9 or 10. There's even more right here. It is unbelievable how many turkeys there are in Yucatan. But yeah, the main thing in the early game, if you guys are new and focusing on it, you guys want to focus on always keeping your town center doing something. If you can keep your town center always producing something, whereas either producing a villager, going up the next age, or researching a tech, that is the main thing. And also a main thing is evenly distributing your resources to what you need at that moment. So early game, it's big on food and some wood. You want 6 villagers on your food at the beginning. Keep them under the town center, much as possible. And then use your turkey, sheep, llamas, whatever it is for that current map, and get those early. You don't want to build farms too early because you're going to need that wood to go up in ages. So I got my wood choppers, and you want to keep the wood chop, the like lumber camp, as close to the logs you're cutting, so the walk distance is smaller. Because the farther away, the more your villagers have to walk, that means less resources you're getting. I see I got a pack of deer over there. I'm going to definitely be getting that soon, and I drop a mill on the berries. Now, one thing I do a lot, one mistake I make a lot, is the berries. They don't give you a ton. They have a lot of food, but you don't gather from them very fast. At all. It's very slow when you gather from the berries. So definitely don't put all your villagers on berries right away. Use them as sort of a late night, and don't do this. See, you don't want to be pop locked. Mine was a little late. What you want to do is say 2-3 villagers. You want to build I do say a good rule of thumb is 3 villagers. So 3. So you had 12, so 15 out of 20. When I hit 17 out of 20 population, that is when I want to build my next house. It'll guarantee that I won't be pop-blocked. Pop-blocked meaning I cannot build another anymore because I don't have the population room to accommodate for it. But yeah, definitely also, you want to scout for your boar. You want to find your 2 boar on the map because you want a boar lure. It's very important. If you don't know how to do it, definitely learn. I will show an example up here. I'm not very good at it yet, and I'm not very efficient, but I know how to do it. And also scout for your secondary deer. Just always deer. Mine are up in the top left. Here, I'll take off the view light. Mine are up here. And I have a boar here, and I have a boar here. I found my 2 boar. And then once I have found all the things I need, I know where my gold is here. I know where my stone is. Just right here. I also had almost terrible spawns of gold. Like, my stone on the outside, at least this one's in the back. This gold's in the front. It's not a good thing. And also, after you've scouted those out, then you can go scout out your enemy. That's what I like to do, anyway. I don't know if that's right, but that's what I like to do. Keeping my my town center, always doing something. I'm luring in some turkeys. I like to keep my turkeys in the outside, because if I'm not paying attention, like this, he's doing a good job. Now see how he garrisoned his villagers that were around there while he's collecting from the boar? He gathered, good lord, game talk right now. He garrisoned his units, his villagers, in the town center and allowed him to attack my scout. That's one thing I did not do and should've, and it's very good to deny scouting information. So I have no idea what he's going for now, and I lost my scout, which is a big detriment early game. It really hurts me. I'm not going to be able to see, and I have no idea when his next attack is. Now, I'm going... I'm usually around, I don't know, 18, 19 population. I throw down a mining camp, and I put two on gold. I only have one on right now. I should have two. I'll reallocate some another villager to that. But here's a mistake I do. See, I have five. I have six villagers on the... bushes right away. And you don't want to do that. I should have brought them here to kill these or to bring them and get the deer. Or lure a boar. Because I actually have three that I can get to. This one's a bit far, but I can still get to it. Now you can see I'm starting to wall off. I know he killed my scout. I have no scouting information, so I'm doing this very preemptively to stop from any aggression. Now, I do have a very good map generation for walling off, though. As I've scouted, he can't go through this way. He can only get through here, which I can wall off very easily. He can't get through anything here, but he can go through the back. So I just have to wall off here, and I have to wall off here, which I'm already starting to do, and you'll be all set. Now, what I do, instead of just using a palisade wall and putting a palisade wall all the way across, it's a good idea to wall big areas like that, but the trouble with it is it's very weak. It only has 250 health, a palisade wall, which is not very strong. Instead, I'm using buildings, 1200. They have higher armor and higher health points. So it helps a lot in the early game, especially against rushes. I mean rushes, archer rushes, knight rushes. It's very hard to get through buildings compared to palisade walls. And one mistake I'm not doing is luring a boar. It's great that I'm using up all the turkeys and I have the ability to do that, but the boar is so much food early and it gives you such a jump. As I just go up to the feudal age now at 26 villagers. I usually should go up around like 24, 23. The reason I went up later is just because that I know I have a very walled off position. I can wall off very well. You can also use houses. I can wall off very well, and I can play defensive. And since I have no scouting information, I have very little ability to play aggressive here. I don't know where he's going. I don't know how he's building. I don't know what he's going for, and it can be very scary. I'm starting to continue my wall off there, and I'm finish off my wall off there. That's good. I have a hunter that's going to lure this boar, apparently. But I've walled him off. And see, this is what you don't want. You don't want idle villagers. And since I screwed up my boar lure... Anyway, so how to boar lure? You take your hunter, and you shoot it twice. I only shot it once. See? Mistakes are made. And I figure, it's too far, I'm not going to do it. So I just... And I've been too idle. So I just bring the mill here, and I'm going to go after the deer. Did I even boar lure this game? God, I am a scrub. How did I not boar lure this whole game? I got to the feudal age a little later than he did, because he went up with less villagers, I'm pretty sure. Let's find out. Yeah, he went up with 23 villagers. Compared to mine, I went up with 26. And I'm throwing down the archer range now, and I'm shooting my deer. Now, one thing you want to do is you want four villagers per deer. And you don't want them to shoot all the deer. You want to shoot one at a time because it decays. And if excuse me. Oh my god, excuse me. And if you don't have all your villagers on there at once, if you have to have a minimum of four. You can have more, but it's not as efficient. But you have to have four, otherwise it decays. And you can't use the decay rate. And you're going to, when your villagers leave to drop off the food, it'll be decaying while it's there. As you can see, I'm starting to go for archers right now. I'm going for a bit of archer rush. Because I know I'm behind. Well, I know I'm ahead a little bit. Score is tough to decide, but when it's within 100 or 200, it's very... That doesn't really indicate if you're behind or ahead. I got the blacksmith down. I'm going to go for fletching. Give me a plus one range and plus one attack on my archers. And what I'm doing is I'm garrisoning them in here just in case he can see. If he has any like scouts or anything, he could see my archers sitting outside. Now, one thing I didn't notice, as you can see as I released the fog of war, is he's got two stables going down as a proxy. I don't see this. It's over here and I have no clue. And that's what hurt me early. Losing that scout, I would still be scouting around. I would have all this scouted. And if I didn't see him having any military buildings around, I would have started scouting around my own base. But at this point I don't. And I let a scout in. I didn't know that this wasn't walled off. It's so hard to tell. So what you do is you just take like a palisade wall and you tell it to build like that area. And you can see if there's like any spots where they could get through. It's really aggravating. But he got in and he sees the flags on my archer ranges. The flags mean that there's people garrisoned. And he knows that there's not going to be villagers garrisoned in there. So, he's assuming it's an archer rush. Which he's very right. Now, I should have left a little earlier and then brought them over, but I didn't. And I have three villagers just chilling here, not doing a thing. They should be working, but they're trying to go after these deer and they can't reach. The AI is broken. So he gets there, and he goes for a quick castle. And I'm not even going to the castle age yet. I'm like, oh crap, this is not good. And he tried to... I bought a spearman and stabbed him. And I released my archers to go and attack. I got the plus one. It's not a super strong, just how late it is. Like, this is way too late for a push. And I scout that he has the stable there. I'm like, yay, nice. I have spearmen. I really need pikemen. Pikemen are much better against knights and spearmen. And it's a bit late for me to do this. If I was going to do this, I should have done it earlier. He's already in the castle age. It's 18 minutes in the game. This is way too late of a push. And as you can see, he's already got knights following me. And it's not going to go well for me. It was bad luck that he was knight rushing me and I was going into archers. But it's also way too late. So what I do is I just try and snipe some villagers. I try to get in here and disrupt any economy I can, because I know these are going to die. I'm not going to be able to fight off 5-6 knights. And I don't even end up killing a single villager. I lose, and I keep building more, and now I'm stopping, obviously. And I'm building spearmen, because I saw the mass amount of knights. The only good thing this is doing, it's stopping him from getting into my base. He's not attacking me because he's focused on these archers, which is kind of a saving grace, but I'm losing a lot for it. As we can see, I have more villagers than him. My economy is a little better, but he has the military lead right now. So I, again, trying to do anything I can to do any damage, but I'm not doing it. As I continue to queue up spearmen. And I need some upgrades, which I'm not doing. I have 870. I'm trying desperately to get into the castle age. I'm trying so hard. And one thing that could have helped me is if I threw down a market. A market, I can buy the necessary resources and then queue up to the castle age. Because I need castle age really quickly to be able to defend this push. I finally queue up to the castle age at 21 minutes. It's really late. And I'm just praying to God I can defend this. I'm building a second barracks because I need to get out more spearmen. Because I know it's knights. I know it's coming. The good thing is I'm so compact in here. It's going to be very hard for him to break this. So he's probably going to have to come through here. And my town center, since my base is so crunched in here, it's very good for me because I can defend it well with my town center. I can garrison my villagers in the town center, and it'll be very hard for his knights to get through. Now I'm really like scared because he's waiting a lot. And I'm like, oh god, what is he waiting for? Is he trying to find a way through my base? How many knights does he actually have now? Which is still good for me. It makes me scared, in the back of my mind. God, such good music right now. Sorry, I love this. This is my favorite song. But, and here he is. He is officially on my palisade walls. This is what I was saying earlier about the palisade walls. Against knights, they hold up for about 4 seconds, and it's already dead. But I had a good wall off here, and I have a good amount of spearmen, but he has a good amount of knights. He's also got, he did well and went for the armor upgrades first. That's what you want to do. And I'm starting to build some houses here. And I'm trying to wall off certain areas, and I want to funnel them into my town center. And what I'm doing is I'm not finishing building them, I'm just getting them up a little bit. My villager walked outside like an idiot instead of walking where I wanted to. And now I got my spearmen in there, hopefully going to do some damage. I should have probably engaged him under the town center, but as you can see, spearmen are not strong enough yet. Like, they do counter them, but they're not. I need pikemen, basically. But I do a good job of that, and see how I forced him in toward the town center. Now I would have lost less if he went around. And since he didn't go around and wasn't able to get in there, I was able to save a bunch of them. And now I'm trying to build up more spearmen. I'm upgrading to pikemen, which is going to help tremendously. Pikemen have a much stronger counter to knights. They have a very high bonus against cavalry, and it's much higher. As you can see, it does a lot of damage. Granted, 1 versus 3, I'm going to lose. I need more than just one pikeman. And I'm losing a lot of villagers. My population is down to 25. This is not looking good for me. My economy is terrible right now because everybody's garrisoned up. He's got more knights here. As we look at his point of view, he's starting to build up his economy again because he feels like he's in a very big lead, which he is. And he's building up more villagers and getting his economy going, because mine is actually the garbage right now. And he's trying to bust down this archery range, because he wants to be able to come in this way, instead of having to walk all the way around. The one mistake he made was he just kept attacking with these outside ones, instead of like continuing to come here and attacking like my forage bushes or attacking my tree line, he decided to attack that with his outside ones. I got 3 free knights for nothing. So I'm like, okay, if he's going to attack my archery range, then I'm going to sit out here and I'm just going to continue to build up pikemen where I know I can win the fight. Which I end up doing. I have 6 pikemen here. 7 pikemen. And again, he makes a mistake of just throwing these knights away for free. And I ended up cleaning up these knights, and there was no reason for him to attack this. Like, what good is him attacking the second one? And I clean up his knight attack for no reason. I didn't need to. He didn't need to throw those away. So I saw he has a siege workshop here too, which would have been what he should have done, is waited. If he waited for a siege ram or something and started hitting this with a siege ram, it would have been much harder for me to deal with. And now I really need to get my economy back up. My economy is hurting terribly. I have no villagers. I mean, the population is 32 to 34. Granted, the population is very intact, but I have like 10 pikemen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I got 8, 9 pikemen. That's not villagers. His is all villagers. Granted, he was a bit complacent and was not focusing on his economy much during that attack, which is something that while you're rushing, you want to focus on your economy as well. Helps a lot. And allows you to have something to fall back on. I try and repair the wall so he doesn't go through the same spot. Because, you could sneeze on that and blow over. The pile of sticks that I call a wall. Man, I cannot believe I didn't boar lure at all this game. Wow. I apologize, guys. That is terrible. Don't do that. Ever. That's a poor move. And one problem I find out later is that I'm jammed in here. I cannot get out. I have no room for farms. I am stuffed in here like a sardine. I'm trying to get a second town center out, increase my villager production, and also, if he gets in here again, through here, I'll be able to defend a lot easier if I have 2 town centers rather than just 1. And I'm continuing to, I'm not building any military because I know for a fact I need to get my economy back up. I know I'm behind. The score is pretty even because of military kills, but I know for a fact I'm behind. How are my upgrades on them? The upgrades are eh. I definitely could get better upgrades, but I'm focusing so heavy on economy because I have 41 food. I can't even afford villagers. I can't afford anything. So now we're in this economy mode here, and he's starting to build up more knights. Which, I don't know how I feel about this. I mean, the knights are good, but I have pikemen now, and pikemen are pretty cost efficient against knights. I'd be going more long swordsmen or some archers to try and fight off the pikemen. He's going archer range, yeah. He's going to cavalry archers. And he's also going up in his economy, but I also have the two town centers now compared to his one. So my economy is going to be stronger now. And I'm just stabbing a building with a spear. That's gonna, as you can tell, it would take a while to kill it. And it does take a while to be able to kill that with kill building with spearmen. Not a very good counter to buildings. Oh jeez, I feel my voice going already. Oh, I've recorded a good amount today. But yeah, we got and now I see that he's got the cavalry archers and he's got the knights. And I throw away my pikemen for nothing. Granted, they're cheap, it's not like throwing away knights. But they all do get cleaned up. And I see them and I start building skirmishers. And I do not have elite skirmishers, I really do need the upgrade. Elite skirmishers and skirmishers are very good counter to archers. And they're good against cavalry archers. Pikemen are also good against cavalry archers, but they get kited. So I'm here hawking my indefinite spears at people. And one thing that I did pretty good in this was, again, like I said, the house's position. If he tries to get through here, he has no option to go up and through this area, which he has to go through two town centers to get into any of my economy. Same with here. I've walled this up. He can't, if he gets through here, he has to go through here, or he has to go through here. He can't attack my economy directly. He's got the battering ram now, which is smart. Archers suck against battering rams. See that 180 pierce armor? That's huge. This is your melee armor, the one on the left, and the one on the right is your, like, against archers. That's your pierce armor. And this is your melee armor. So rams have a huge, I only do one damage a shot against battering rams. But what I do is I reinforce this all with stone walls. Stone walls, much better. Very hard to get through without siege weapons. You can do it with knights and whatnot, but it takes forever. And he left his units left here. So I'm like, uh-oh, he's coming from behind, which I saw that. And you see again how I didn't build all the buildings right away. I just built them up, since they build up really quick, I built them up only to half. So it's still gonna be very hard and buy me time. It's gonna be very hard for him to get through, but it's also gonna buy me time. That's a very good strategy if you like have to build something instantly. Don't finish it. Just build all of it. And once they're all built, it acts as a wall, even though it's not completed. But it has to be started. They can go through like just the squares around it. So like if I throw down a building and it just has the marked off spots, they can go through that. And now he's dropping a castle on me. Which is very smart. I have no way how to deal with that. I don't have any siege. And I don't even have a siege workshop yet. And he's got quite the army outside. And I'm just sitting here trying to buy time for myself. I know that's a castle. I got some skirmishers up. I'm trying to kill some of these cavalry archers. But I really need the elite skirmisher upgrade, which I have going up right now. It makes a huge difference. Skirmishers compared to elite skirmishers are big, just like the pikemen from the spearmen upgrade. It's a big difference. He's got two rams out now, so it's looking hairy for me. I've been on the back foot all game. So I back up, and then I use an archer range because I needed a building that to fit that area. I want to funnel him into here. If I can get him to fight me in here with the support fire in my town center, it'll help a lot. I'm just basically giving up these production structures here and being like, okay, This is how I gotta do it. And I need to throw a bunch of people on stone, because I only have 200 stone right now. And I need a castle. I really need a castle as defense. That's a main goal for me right now. And it's looking pretty grim. I got my elite skirmisher upgrade. I really need to get into more upgrades. Really badly. Like, I don't have bodkin arrow for my archers. Gives me plus 2. So it'll be 3 plus 2 and 5 plus 2 on my range and attack. And I really need melee attack for my pikeman. Because that is a scary army. And he is... That is cavalry archers and archer and cavalry. The one trouble is very gold intensive. And it's very expensive for him. So yeah, I got one... This is what I have to do. I have to slowly pick at him. I got one to follow me. I was using my skirmishers, and I'm trying to bait him in. I'm using him, I'm attacking him, and I'm hoping he doesn't control it, and the AI just walks into here. Now, the trouble is he's taking out all my production structures. I don't have another barracks back here. I had to build this one, and I'm building a second one now, too. And I'm on the ropes here. He's killing all my production structures. It's very hard for me to deal with this. And warnings everywhere, because I'm hurting. The trouble is I had to pull away from this gold, and I have to use this gold patch back here, because his cavalry archers and everything would kill that. And now he's got mangonels to take care of my group's units. It's looking rough. Oh, sorry about that. Ugh. And now I'm pop-blocked, which is very hard in a case like this, because I'm so jam-packed in here. I have no room for buildings. And the mangonel shots are really hurting, and I really need to take care of these. And he's baiting out. He's doing what I was doing earlier. He's baiting some of my pikemen. And then they just get cleaned up for nothing. As he starts taking out my damn houses. And I continue to be pop-blocked. I throw down a watchtower just to help. And I garrison. Now he's going for the town center kill. He's got the rams, he's got the knights, and he thinks he can kill it. And it will be close. I need to bring my pikemen to go and focus on the rams. The rams do so much damage. I pull a couple of villagers off to try and repair this as it's going down. And it's going to be close. We're at 600, but I'm evening the DPS, and I wiped out all of that army. That was his mistake right there. He threw away his whole army for basically nothing. He put damage on my town center. But he lost everything because of that. That was a huge mistake by him. He should have starved me out. If he could have waited out here, he had the castle, right? He should have went in a big economy bonus. But see, he's not doing it. He thinks he has his game won every time, and he's being complacent. He has no one's farming. He hasn't moved his lumber camps up. He's not building villagers, and his population's down to 54. Excuse me. Now he's going back and reseeding his farms, and it's hurting him a lot. Granted, his economy is probably still in the lead, but he threw away his whole army because of that. Just to attack my town center, and it's full health again. He didn't accomplish anything there. And I have the 2 town center advantage still. That really hurt him. He should not have thrown everything he had in there. Granted, my economy got hurt as well. But I still have this second town center. Does he see this? I'm really curious. Now he's got to know it's there. He sees that see that different look? So here's grass, and here's that, like, gray. It's, like, brownish with some gray in it. That means there's a building there. So, he knows it's there. He might not know it's the town center, but he knows it's there. Now he's just having them attack my palisade walls, whatever. But I have the economy bonus, and now I have a castle down. Which is going to help defense a lot. But the trouble is, as I said earlier, I am jammed in here. I have nowhere to go. I am stuck in here. I can't push out yet. I need Imperial Age to push out, because I need a trebuchet to take out this. He has too many knights for me to be able to use battering rams. Or mangonels don't have the range. And I'm getting a siege workshop, because I need probably going to go mangonels. They're a good counter for his group's units, and they're a good counter against his mangonels. Also, if I can keep the Rems alive, it'd be good to go that way. But, as you can see, I'm starving for room right now. Room is becoming difficult. Trying to get my castle up, but this whole time I'm building villagers. Because you always build villagers. You want half of your population is villagers. So, it's 200 population in this game, so I want 100 villagers. Maybe a little more, say 100, 110. So you can sustain your economy, and that's huge. That's what a lot of new players don't do. I'm still a new player, but I know a lot of new players to the game do not, like, they don't keep their economy up enough. And that's the main thing. If you can keep your economy up by building a ton of villagers, you're going to be successful. And I am trying my best. I'm running out of room. Everywhere, I got no room. And I can't get through these walls because I still have no scouting information. That's one thing I should have done too. I know I got a castle here, but I bet I could run like an eagle warrior around the side or something. And just see his base. Because I still have no scouting information. I have no idea what he's going. I'm just going off of what I saw last time. So now I'm getting some plumed archers and he's building some light cavalry. No idea why. He knows I have tons of pikemen. Those are not really going to help him. I know that he's trying to find like a trash unit. Trash unit means it doesn't cost gold. And he's spent a lot of gold already. Cavalry archers, knights, and he has a castle, so I'm assuming Tarkins. And Tarkins are all gold. Gold heavy. My army, no gold in here. Pikemen and skirmishers are all trash units. I'm not spending any gold. As you can see, I have floating 1,400. And now I'm pumping out some plumed archers. Because I figure that he's going to be building some infantry to stop this. Long swordsmen and stuff are very good against skirmishers and pikemen. Got a ram up. Building a couple rams because I need to push this off. And I have a ton of gold. So I know, okay, if I get enough food, then I'll be able to get to the Imperial Age. Imperial Age is when we get trebuchets. Trebuchets is going to allow me to take out that castle. Because that's what's keeping me in my base right now. As we all are fighting for room here. I have no room to put farms down. I have no room for anything, really. Torn down in our lumber camp, trying to get more people to chop wood. But I'm so crunched in here. Just trying to use them for scouting information, which is good. Sees that I have a castle now. That's what was so huge about that first jump. He wasn't using economy behind it, and he threw away his whole army. And that allowed me to build back my economy. I got a castle, the second town center. I have a lot of food now. My population's pretty big. Now I'm just baiting in these things. He's bringing this in, trying to scout what I have in here. He sees my composition. He sees what I have. So he's going scorpions, which are pretty good. They attack through a line. They're very good against like grouped up units like that. But I don't know if I would have went so heavy. I would have went more mangonels. I feel like mangonels do a better job of than them. Here's a huge army of Tarkins. That's going to be hard to deal with. I don't have... But, again, he's making the same mistake as he did before. And guys, if you guys are in your game, do not make this mistake. He's running in here. There is a castle, a watchtower. There are people in... Do I have people in this? I don't think I have anybody. But still. He's just running his guys in here for nothing. There's three different things shooting him. And he's not attacking my units. I mean, he's attacking some of my units, but he's also attacking this town center. It's less units he has attacking my actual units. And I'm just picking them off for free. Granted, he's getting close. I mean, we're at 400 health, and I got some guys repairing as fast as possible. But again, it's not enough. I'm pumping out pikemen like crazy. I got plumed archers coming. He's doing a very good job of picking off units. 120, wow, it is close. But nope, not enough again. 120 health. And he focused so much on killing that town center. What would that have helped? Even if he killed it, what would that have done? Nothing. I have another one back here. It's not like this is my only town center. And he scouted it. He knows that's a town center, does he? He knows that's gotta be it. But he threw away his whole army again. Into the meat grinder. It's great for me. But he threw it away. I need to keep my villagers on. But again, he thinks he's won the game. He's being complacent. He is being complacent. 61 population. He's not reseeding his farms. He has a second town center, but he's not building villagers out of it. Now he is, because he just threw away his army. If he was building economy behind this, I would have lost this game already. But since he's not, and he's still throwing his units in here. He still thinks he can kill it. He knows I'm repairing it. And he's just throwing his units away. My population's greater than his. I have a greater military than he does. And I have a stronger economy now. He killed a lot of villagers that time, granted. But as you can start seeing, the score difference starting to show it. I've killed way more units than he has. My army's bigger. And I'm on the way to the Imperial Age. It's going to hurt him. As soon as I get trebuchets, it's going to die. And then I'll be able to push out. And he... As he's acted before, it's going to be tough for him to be able to do it. It's going to be tough for him to be able to come back. That's twice he's done that. And he's just thrown away his lead twice. That really hurt. Good for me, but... I mean, I did a good job, but I mean, he threw it rather than... It was more him throwing than me winning. I did what I needed to do, but... If he attacked my units, would have been tough. If it was me in his position, I would have starved this person out. I have this here. I know I would scout around to make sure he had nothing like hidden. No, nothing hidden around. And then I would have starved him out. I would have got my economy huge, got into Imperial Age, and then just got trebuchets, parked them right here. It would have forced me out, attacked me, wiped me, and that would have been game. There would have been nothing he could have done. I could have even come up here. My trebuchets can sit out here and I could attack that town center. I could attack that castle. Nothing I could have done. I don't have the range. And I don't have any like cavalry to march out there. I have Eagle Warriors, which I have not upgraded. Right now I'm just keeping building pikemen, plumed archers, and elite skirmishers. Going super trash. Cause I have nothing right now to supplement it. I'm basically waiting for Imperial so I can get a trebuchets out, and then I'm gonna push out for this. That's basically all I'm waiting for. I'm pretty sure he's not even going for Imperial yet. Nope, he is. He's got Imperial as well. Yep, and he sees that I've gone to the Imperial Age. And he's got nothing at home. He's got some military stuff here. He's got 4 cavalry, but he's not producing anything off of it. And he's got 7 targets. That's all he's got. And 58 population. He's not building enough villagers. I got 111. I'm doubling his population right now. Much bigger economy. I'm still building villagers. It's a very, very key thing. I'm still building villagers. I'm still building military. Trebuchets are starting to come out. And this is going to be a very, very tough problem for me. One thing I should have done better, their upgrades. I got the Bodkin Arrow for my plumed archers, which is good. And my skirmishers, but I don't have melee for that. And now we got the trebuchets out, and I can park him in my base for the range. And there's nothing he can do about it. He got to the Imperial Age, but it's a little late. You get the adversity, and I can upgrade chemistry. And there it is right there. There's my chemistry upgrade. Gives a +1 attack onto my trebuchets, which is pretty significant. And any siege weapons, onagers and stuff like that. And gunpowder units, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, sure. But yeah, now there's nothing he can do about it. I can shell at this from the safety of my base. And I'm really starting to run out of room. I have no room to put any houses. It's terrible. As I just shell away at this. Now it's just... He's got a... It's a waiting game, really. I need to be able to push out. Just about maxing the room of stuff I can put. There was a sentence there, Alec. Everything's starting to be too jam-packed. Get chemistry up. and he has lost his castle. Now I have free roam to come out. I can finally get out of my base. I have a little breathing room now. He's not breathing down my neck. Thank God. Starting to bring my trebuchets out. And I can see his army. It's all cavalry. And I have a lot of pikemen supplemented by archers. I should be able to do... Should be able to fight that off pretty well. I was building some long swordsmen. Because I was... Again, I'm waiting for him to counter. And he resigned. He saw the army. He did not have it. He had too small of an economy. Wasn't enough for him. Economy's not great enough there. Compared to mine, I have a much stronger economy. And I have a bigger... Yeah, population 69 to whatever, 130. Yeah, 140 basically. You got this, that's why he can't be complacent. He should just starve me out, build up my economy, build up his economy from the back, and we've been all set. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this game. If you did, definitely leave a like and comment below. If you guys wanted me to do like a quest or something, I was thinking about doing it, not 100% sure if I will yet. Like a quest 1800, you know what I mean? I'll do it live, I'll record him live. And I'll just try and get to 1800. I'll 1v1 with opponents similar. This guy was like 1630, 1640, like me. But yeah, we can check the achievements. Military, see, about pretty even because I had a lot of trash units, but his were so much more expensive than mine. He had So, like, knights and Tarkins and Kevrich, all gold. Mine are all trash. Mine didn't cost any gold. At all. So he killed more than I did, but I had a larger army. And the economy. This is what hurt him, too. I had more of this, even though I was jammed in there. He killed me in the gold, that's for sure. But he was spending a lot more gold than I was. And got to the Castle Age much faster. Much faster. That's because I went for that Feudal Age rush, which was late. See how he always had it, and there's the big dips every time. Dip, up, dip, up, dip. If he just waited me out, would have been able to do it. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I definitely did, and if you did, leave a like below, comment below. And yeah, definitely subscribe for more. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you guys next time.